Hi, I'm Bone Girl.
And I'm the Barbarian, and this is Looking for Epic. We look at things that might be epic, decide whether or not they are, and then try to understand why.
9 years after the original movie came out, it had gained enough of a cult following for there to be a sequel, entitled Beastmaster II, Through the Portal of Time. It stars Mark Singer as Dar, but that's about it. Don Coscarelli and Paul Pepperman were not involved in any way. They don't have the same composer, any of the other actors, or even the same distributor. Not only that, but check this out. Yeah, 5 writers. Wow, that is impressive. In my experience, the only thing worse than a whole lot of writers is having multiple directors. And I like how they're spaced out into phases, some being joined by an and symbol and others spaced apart with the actual word, like, these guys wrote it, and it was so bad that this guy had to fix it, and he failed so hard that these two guys were brought in to salvage things.
The one thing they did right with this movie was the title. Giving your film a subtitle like Through the Portal of Time is pretty much the equivalent of having your director go on all the late night talk shows and lean in close to the camera and say, "Stay away."
So this is the Beastmaster.
They call him the Beastmaster, but they let his animals run around free.
Tiger not painted black? What the hell?
A laser? Are you serious, movie?
Well, the music is pretty cool.
We encounter an evil witch who has the awesome power to make people fidget about.
That's my mutant power.
My dear, I am the most powerful man on Earth.
Not for long, unless you allow me to make your power eternal.
You are but a witch.
Oh, maybe, but a very uncommon one.
It's like the villain of this movie doesn't want to have an evil scheme at all. He has to be bullied into it by an aggressive swimsuit model.
Then Dar is attacked by She-Bitch from Army of Darkness, who turns out to be his aunt.
So yeah, I was a good guy and all, but then I got addicted to the evil magics, and now I just run around slaughtering random people in the swamps. So sit down, let me tell you the plot to the first movie, and about your evil brother who was born before you, but also somehow got kidnapped by evil sorcerers!
Dar immediately and completely trusts the hideous hell monster who tried to murder him only 3 minutes ago. Are you serious, movie?
With the threat of such a weapon, I could rule unopposed.
Exactly.
Is this guy Matthew Lillard's father? And then the movie just goes batshit insane.
Jesus, since when did the governor pardon mental patients?
Oh. A Reagan joke. How delightful.
Marcellus? Are we dreaming?
So that's what Marcellus Wallace looks like.
Look, is there a telephone around here maybe that I could use? Or a 7-Eleven even? Something like that?
7-Eleven?
I don't care about your stupid inability to figure out that you're not in LA anymore, or any of your fish-out-of-water humor that springs from the loins of your idiocy.
The animals are free. This is their land. I'm their friend.
Why does Dar talk like he's at a Ren Fest?
She touched his weasel.
And I have to ask, where is Tanya Roberts? This guy just ditched his super hot girlfriend to go run around in the wild with his animals? Pff, furry.
Robert Zadar?
Oh, Zano.
Now, in modern times, or at least the 90s, Dar meets the police, and rather than try talking to him, they just decide to tase him.
Largest city in California, most awesome place in the universe.
The driving in the car scene. Why do I care? This isn't a sword and sorcery movie. This is Crocodile Dundee, George of the Jungle, Blast from the Past. Other movies that don't star Brendan Fraser, but it's not a sword and sorcery movie.
The bad guy steals the bomb from a pipe factory where the dog one hangs out.
We'll see if you mock me in the room of questions.
They fight across the city and end up in some kind of WCW medieval times theme circus, where a voice on a loudspeaker and the laser lights from the Who show that Ridley Scott used in Alien attempt to add a sense of drama to this final showdown that the story has completely failed to create on its own.
Dar delivers his Schwarzeneggerian catchphrase.
Asshole.
And the bomb is deactivated just in time.
Yeah? Hey? Stopped it?
There are two ways to look at this film, as a movie in its own right and as a sequel to Beastmaster, and it fails at both. I see what they were going for. They were trying to rip off Masters of the Universe. The films are so blatantly similar, it's really embarrassing.
The question is, why would you do that? Masters of the Universe was 4 years old at this point. Nobody remembered it. When it came out, it was terribly reviewed. It barely made back its production costs. Why would you try and rip off a movie that was a failure when it came out originally? Why not try and rip off a good movie? Why not have Terminators come back to the future to kill Dar because his son someday is going to be the king of mankind? I mean, it's like they're trying to pick the pocket of a homeless man.
And even if the movie had worked, you'd be like, yeah, it was okay, it's a comedy, but it has nothing to do with Beastmaster. It's kind of like Earth Girls or Easy, but with a lot less sensual canola oil massages.
It's like the guy who wrote this movie saw Beastmaster and said, wow, this is terrible. Sword battles and naked girls and guys getting mauled to death by wild animals, that all has to go. We need goofy cops, two really annoying female leads, and a never-ending stream of humorless observations about how Los Angeles differs from the ancient world. People go to sword and sorcery movies for two reasons: to see unfunny rehashes of 1930s comedy routines and stupid girls talking to ferrets. That's why they have the word sword and sorcery in the description.
This movie seriously reminds me of Laser Blaster more than Beastmaster. Think about it. They drive around in a convertible. They stand in the desert a lot. There's a big cop and his little cop buddy. All the ancillary characters are like Eddie Deason, and the villain even has a laser blaster. Come on. And sure, it didn't have Bob Zadar, but you know what? It didn't have running jokes about the word bosom either, did it? No!
I could explain all the ways in which the mythology and plot of this movie make no sense, but why bother? That's like continuing to correct some kid's paper after he's already guaranteed himself an F. What's the point of crushing little Jimmy's hopes even further by saying, yes, the rest was wrong too? Let's go to the charts. That's right, where the dirty Pikachus belong.
I give it zero ferrets, because no ferret would be caught dead watching this film. I'm Bone Girl, and I have better things to do.
And I'm the Barbarian. This has been Looking for Epic. I'll be waiting on the moon. Oh, and where is the Black Tiger? Thank you. Okay.
I said that a little more bitterly than I intended to. Furries everywhere, grab their animals! No!
I can't sleep, furries, look at me.
Okay. Neville has to watch out.
We're gonna do Rob.